Mark was a pupil at Bolton School from 1966 to 76. He's meeting up with his old classmates Ross Warburton and Andy Wright, who were also in his first band, Berlin Airlift.
Do you ever remember that wah-wah pedal you built me?
Was it the wooden one?
Yeah, it was made out of wood.
Ross had an electric guitar and an amplifier. His parents were quite wealthy. And then Andy had a bass, but he couldn't play it. So on the first gig, he pretended to play it. But the mistake he made was that on top of all the speakers, he'd left a book that says, how to play bass guitar.
Before judging the competition, Mark's been invited for lunch with the headmaster, who's dug out an old file on Mark that, with hindsight, holds some interesting observations.
He is a boy who has not completely fulfilled his academic promise. He has considerable ability, but because of his musical interest, he has not given as much time to his work as he ought to.
This is your modern music choice on the back of here. That presumably is you writing there.
I enjoy modern music by groups such as Genesis and the Strokes.
That's brilliant.
And attend many live performances by such groups. I also enjoy playing with the group on drums and singing. It's extraordinary. From my mum, my son, M. Radcliffe, was unable to attend school on Tuesday due to biliousness. Can you still stay off school for biliousness?
Me and your two presenter at an Old Boy Mark School, Mark Radcliffe.
As the battle of the bands gets underway, Mark reflects on when he, Ross and Andy were boys their age playing in Berlin Airlift.
Much better equipment than we ever had.
Oh, yeah. So have you? Drum kits were incredibly expensive. I would get one drum for my birthday, a snare drum, a white snare drum. And then for the next year, I remember getting a bass drum, which was really amazing to get, a full-size bass drum. But then I didn't get a pedal for the next birthday.
It's fantastic to be back. Thank you for inviting me. I've been in the headmaster's office, which still makes me feel a bit scared, even at the age of 52. And we've been looking back through my old reports, which said could do better if he didn't concentrate so much on music, which is all I was interested in. It actually turns out that concentrating on music has served me a lot better than actually concentrating on my schoolwork. But I'm not so. I think being in a band is primarily about creativity. And so I'm going to give this prize to the band who performed the final song, which they composed themselves. So I award this to the Battleship Line.
To finish off his trip to Bolton, Mark's going to Lostock Tennis Club. The scene of his first drumming performance in 1972 at Berlin Airlift's inaugural gig.
Looks like we're here.
It's the first time that he, Ross and Andy have been back since.
The last time I was in this car park, I was 14 years old. And it did give me a little kind of thump in the stomach, I'll be honest with you, when I saw that building and turned into this car park. It's sort of an extraordinary feeling. I wasn't expecting that, to be honest. This really is where it begins, thinking, I want to be a drummer. When you think of the kind of journey from being 14 and coming in and playing the drums to coming back now, well, that's a lot of water under the bridge and other assorted cliches. But it is. It is. It's a bit hard. It's sort of strangely hard to take in. Odd. But there it is. Lostock Tennis Club. Playing the first gig, it was just thrilling. It was utterly thrilling.
The home of British tennis.
And British rock, mate.
Oh, yes.
It was in this suburban tennis club that Mark's love affair with music was firmly cemented.
If it had gone badly that night, would any of the rest of it happen? Who knows? Who knows? But definitely it was love from that night. I suppose it's lodged in my mind as an important day in my life, really.
We were in this corner. Yeah. Tim Lesnar would be there on his Echo Ranger 6.
Hi. We're all turning in to face you for confidence, I think. Very few 14-year-old boys in 1972 could play a set of drums. So, I mean, he was fairly unique.
Yeah.
I remember there's a guy who introduced us.
Yeah.
Yeah. And he stood, I think, in front of you, and he said something, and then he swung the mic round to me, yeah, thinking, Christ, we've actually got to do this now.
For us, it was something that we did to fill in our spare time as an alternative to underage drinking. But for Mark, it was, you know, it was something, you could tell it was something he was going to carry on doing.
Were you turned on for any of it?
I believe I was turned on for some of it, yes.
There's no recordings of it. I imagine it was awful.
I think so, yeah.
But it was the first thing I found when I really felt, oh, yeah, this is it.
Have you seen this? Yeah. That's us.
See, you're wearing those very fashionable dungarees.
I haven't been dungarees. And girls were quite impressed.
Yeah.
Which they hadn't,
whole point.
Which they hadn't been before.
There I am, 14 years old, up there playing that ragged collection of tatty old drums, dreaming somewhere in me head under my big bush of hair that it was going to end up at Nebworth or the Reading Festival or wherever it was going to be. But there was no doubt that was what was going to happen in my head.
Did we play Paranoid?
Yes, we would have played Paranoid.
We would have played Paranoid. Yeah. Johnny be good, get it on, get back.
Yeah. Summertime Blues, we definitely.
Summertime Blues would have been in. Yeah.
Yeah.
It would.
I think I value my past more now as I get a bit older than I ever did.
Yeah.
I mean, that stirred up a lot of feelings and a lot of emotions.
Should we book it again then?
You mean for the comeback gig? Yeah.
For the comeback gig. Yeah. Berlin facelift.
Better than chairlift, that's for certain.